Hello, everyone. Along with Eddie Olczyk, Ray Ferraro coming up. I'm Mike Emmerich, and now we've reached a game three, and the team that's on the road lost the first two. So how do they approach this one?
Well, I think you got to go to history, Doc. There have been plenty of teams that have lost the first two games at home and have gone on to win the series. So all you need to do is win game three. There's pressure on us, yes, but the home team needs to take advantage of that. So if I'm the coach of the visiting team, as I'm looking at my team getting off to a really good start and learning from what we did not get accomplished in the first two games of the series.
Hartford's put themselves in a tough spot, but it takes four games to win a series. In order to do that, this game three is a must. If I'm the coach of the visiting team, the biggest sell job I have is to get your players to believe you can get back in this series with a win here in game three.
Okay, so let's look at the starting goaltenders for the game. From a win last game, we'll try to keep playoff momentum with this game. The pressure of the playoffs did him in last time, but he's back in there tonight, looking for a chance of redemption. These two teams are ready to play, and we're ready to watch. Along with Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, I'm Mike Emmerich, and this playoff game is underway.
Grab!
Play stopped. It's Ray Ferraro time.
The Stampeders got out of the gate in this conference final series like a house of fire. Up 2-0, they dominated major portions of the first two games.
They won that battle in the dots. As that point pass as well. Roosevelt's tripped up. That should be a penalty. Hartford's got two on this one for tripping.
Well, in desperation mode, all he was trying to do was sweep the puck away, but unfortunately caught the player's skates.
The Stampeders will send out their power play unit for the first time.
The numbers show if you get the first goal, you have a way better chance to win than if you're chasing the game. A power play, what a great chance here to get on the board first.
1:07.
Nice save there. They're going to have to do better than that to beat him. Very important steal for him. Good defensive read with that one. And holds on to that puck to get the whistle. Hartford's got that win. The Stampeders with a neutral zone possession along the way. A stick comes up, and a penalty will be called. Hartford's picked up a double minor, 4 minutes in penalties. Every game presents a fork in the road opportunity, and this is it. It's a long 5-on-3 power play, and it begins now.
One of the biggest mistakes a 5-on-3 power play makes is they're looking for the perfect shot. The more you shoot it, the more you move the penalty killers around and you start to tire them out.
He's got it in deep. Outstanding save. What magic to even get the shot away.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop.
On the outside, a shot. Score! A power play goal, and it's a biggie.
See if they can continue the momentum gained with this power play goal as they head out for the next shift.
Halifax is ahead by one goal here in the first period. A lot of time still left to play, but getting one and breaking the tie was huge. They've got the draw.
Scored on the power play by number 50.
Gathered up by Skilly.
By number 42.
Just walking the tightrope. Poke checked away. Oh, what a hit that one was.
Doc, no surprise there. We expected a physical game, and we're going to get one. That early hit is just an example of what we're going to see.
decides he wants the corner. Let's a shot go. Oh, what a save. He brought his best shot, and it got stopped. Is able to move on in. Propelled to Skilly. Oh, and blocked away. He's got it there. He wants to clear it out. He finally got it out of there. Halifax is in their own end, hoping to make a play to center. And he's tripped, and there'll be a penalty. Looks over his options from the corner. And the change is made. The goalie's at the bench. Extra man on in this delayed call. A big one-timer. Hit the post on the outside. Blum's headed to the penalty box. A minor for tripping.
He's got great stick positioning. Stick is on the ice, but unfortunately takes the skates out from under him.
A 5-on-3 power play. This is where special teams really make a difference.
You're right, Doc. This is a big advantage here. 5-on-3 on the power play. It's one you have to capitalize on.
And he throws it in so they can get fresh bodies out there. Shoots one. Wonderful stop. And decides to just cover it up and get the whistle.
Pretty easy save for the goaltender as he just handles that. He handles about 100 of those in practice a day.
A little under 6 minutes gone. Only one goal hanging on the board so far. So it's 1-0. Trying hard to get it out of the zone. So on this power play, they will resume from their own end of the ice. Good place to shoot from. They can't find the target.
From that position on the ice, he's got to hit the net. Make the goalie make a save.
Passing into open ice. Big bad save. And the penalty killers come up big again. It's cleared. Halifax carrying it up the wing. Doesn't get the shot off. Hartford's PK is over. They gave up one.
Well, the goalie will take these all day. His save percentage goes up click, click, click with muffins like this to stop.
And the faceoff's won. In with it now. Tries to get it on net. That puck hit him on the way to the net. Pitching it to Miller. Chip to Klingberg. Tip to the net. Oh, pad stop on the redirect. Such a good stick. That could have been held by a Canadian of the 70s. Has a chance to make a play through the corner. In the slot. What a terrific save. That stick is broken on that shot. Skates out with it. Possession in the zone. Muscled right off. On to Stewart. Driving in from no man's land. Looks ahead to start something. Stole that pass at a critical end of the ice. And he dumps it in. Trying to get it back out of the zone. Halifax in mid-ice skating along the side. Gliding behind, looking. Receives that pass from the other side. Shoots one. Collected in the corner. Collected now. Sends it all the way across. Waits from the corner. A shot. Score! And this one is tied.
I guess this game's not going to spread out. That goal ties it. The teams are so evenly matched.
Neutral zone face-off one. Possession established here.
Dustin Jeffries
takes that pass from the other point man. Hits the post and out. What a heavy collision along the boards.
Oh, he got hit so hard, it looks like his shoulders touched each other. That one's going to leave a mark.
Chooses the corner. Well done with that pass.
Jeffrey's going to learn really quick that you cannot skate around the ice with your head down. You got players looking to knock you into the third row.
Over 4 minutes still to play in this period. Only a pair of goals so far, equally divided. Clean win on the draw. Takes a shot and a save. And he puts the glove on it and stops play. Solid, clean win. The Stampeders carrying on in their own end. Steps in from the neutral zone. Shoots. Outstanding save with the glove. Possession established. Good reach there. Read that play at his own end. Crosses that line. Nearing the final minute of play. Stood him right up.
1 minute left.
Lofted back in, and the forwards get to the bench. The Stampeders are driving it from the wing. It's dumped in. This one being contested on the boards. Trying to go to Stewart. A big collision in the middle of the ice.
Some of the more difficult hits to deliver are one in the open ice. That is a very good one.
One period played, a goal scored each. That's been it. Pretty tight-fisted here after the first.
All right, fans, time for tonight's Lucky Row giveaway. Congratulations to Section 107, Row N. Fan receives a limited edition player's t-shirt. Fans.
The Whalers, on the strength of this game-tying goal, have gotten this contest back even, and maybe they're the team with the edge as we go to break. Period two of our contest is underway, and all even up. Laid on to Gilroy. Got it at the point. Slid to Gilroy. Good job defensively done there. That takes some pressure off with that defensive play. Blocked. Stewart's hooked on the play. There will be a penalty. Halifax has been handed a minor, and the call is hooking.
The referees are looking for this. Anytime you stop skating and reach with your stick and pull on the opponent, you're going to the penalty box.
Hartford special teams will have their first chance of the game.
Just because it's your power play doesn't mean you can take a nap here. You have to work hard and continue to generate chances.
Pitching this one to Blount.
45 seconds.
Propelled to Jeffrey. Fires. He caught it and he holds on. grab there and a good reach and possession. Shot it back out of his own end. Now it's directed to D'Agostini. Canes that offensive line. Gives it to the point. Chip to Blount. On to Jeffrey. Close in shot. Great save at the edge of the crease.
The goalie makes himself look big.
And that one cleared by the penalty killers. Dogged determination there by Blum. Directing that one to Jeffrey. Halifax has taken care of that penalty, so we're back even. Pad save. He throws it there. Score! Two in a row.
You fight so long in a tied game. Now you've got the game-breaking goal. What do you do with it? I think you attack. You try to get another one. Or at the very least, you don't let your opponent breathe.
Hartford's broken the tie and gotten back ahead, and we're still in the second period. Should be fun just to get to the end of this one.
Scored by number 17.
Steps across that line.
Assisted by number 5.
That's a good defensive stick there. An enormous hit.
Oh, he's been looking for that hit all night.
One of those rare games where there's not much scoring, but there's been plenty of chances. The goaltenders have been excellent, and the energy has been high.
Halifax is guilty of a two-minute penalty for tripping.
Oh, this is clearly a tripping call. He made no attempt to play the puck and took the legs out from the attacking player.
Hartford's power play gets another chance to operate. Hasn't been effective yet.
No matter how often you work on the power play, the ones that struggle go back to the same basic tenets. And it's to simplify things. Get it to the point, shoot it, get traffic, retrieve it, shoot it again.
Just a bit under 6 minutes have transpired here in the second. We were tied, and now it's a one-goal game. Slides it to the point. Stole that pass away in his own end. They must retreat and start back again. Snapping a pass to Jokinen. Big hits in open ice.
If you're looking for this type of open ice hit, you better have a good angle, and that's exactly what happened. This is a big-time major collision.
Puck is thrown to Stallburg. And he dumps it in. The X has got it on his stick, trying to clear. And this penalty will wipe out the power play. Pouliot sent to the box, 2 minutes for boarding.
Well, the officials are instructed, Doc, as you know, that anytime a player gets hit from behind in this fashion, it's going to be a penalty.
Four players aside, and so we'll see what develops here.
I like their setup on the power play that scored earlier, Doc. Let's see if they can get it set up again. Move the penalty killers around for a couple of good chances.
Good shooting plays. Save. Pumped, loses it. Scooped up by Joel Ward. Passing one off now to LaPierre. Gets it out. Moving it to Ward. That one's fired back out, and so more time will go off the penalty clock. Quick shot. Score! A power play goal yet again.
You don't get many chances to tie the game up. So tight, 5-on-5. Eventually, you get a power play. You better take advantage, and that's what they've done.
The faceoff, the tie-up, and a solid job from the winger there.
Jonathan Mercier, assisted by number 42.
Good job, he roughed him right out.
He finishes his check here and drives his man right into the boards.
27 seconds.
Fires, save! Oh, another save.
He was in control on both of those saves.
The Whalers skated up on the side. Let's it go. Missed.
There was no way he could look at that shot and be happy with it. He missed the net, and he's directly in the middle of the ice.
By himself. That went off the pad. Jeffrey is tripped, and a penalty should be coming. Hartford's got it in their own end, hoping for center. Got that pass in his own end. Berchi's going to the box. It's a tripping minor.
This is an easy call for the official, Doc. Player made no attempt to play the puck and just tripped up the attacking player. They moved the puck around beautifully on the power play. Just nothing to show for it.
Absolutely. I think you're right, Eddie. Let's see what the team does here. They win it.
They didn't take advantage on the power play earlier in the game. Let's see if they can jump on the board here.
11 minutes, 55 seconds.
And now, after that period of time, we get the whistle and the penalty call. Halifax has a two-minute minor for delay of game. That puck was shot over the glass.
Anytime you shoot the puck from your defensive zone out into the crowd without touching anybody, it's a delay of game.
Every game presents a fork in the road opportunity, and this is it. It's a long 5-on-3 power play, and it begins now.
You don't get too many chances like this, Doc, a 5-on-3 power play. The key is to be aggressive, get the puck to the net, make those three penalty killers move all over the place.
Gathered up again by Julio. Great save. And the penalty killers come up big again. It's clear. Takes it in from the neutral zone. Laid on to Puglia. Got his pad on that one. Back to the point. Incredible save. Makes a shot. Oh, and he missed the net.
Sometimes you rush the shot and end up missing the net. Need to slow things down next time.
Looking to Puglia. Shoots it on. Score!
That was an unforced error taking that penalty. The power play cracks the tie. And it's now a one-goal game.
The Whalers have taken the lead by one. What fork in the road are we headed for with this faceoff? Neutralized faceoff win.
Scored on the power play by number 30.
Shoots one. Missed the net.
Assisted by number 25, Victor Stahlberg, and by number 78.
Has it back deep.
Julio. Time of the goal. 14 minutes, 9 seconds.
Halifax is lugging it along in their own end, shifting gears.
The Whalers' lineup is dangerous, but it's more dangerous because he sits at the top of the goal-scoring chart. He gets a chance, it's in the net. There's no second opportunity.
Puck drop, tie up, and help from the winger. Gains the zone. Gives it over to the point. He cut that one off in the defensive end. Let's it go. That's a great glove save. Takes that pass. Slid to Roosevelt. Oh, deflected away. Wonderful play by the defense. Pass attempt to Bieksa. Oh, an error on that pass. Good chance here. Takes that pass at center. See if we can move something. The drama heightens in this final minute of the second period. Puck ricocheted off the screen. Holds on and gets that whistle.
You can't deliver the puck much better than that, but the goalie said no chance. That's an excellent save.
Nice face-off win. What a heavy hit.
If they keep hitting like this, I'm not sure how much they'll have left in the third.
Out in front. Terrific save with no reaction time whatsoever.
Terrific stop from right in front of the net, but you've got to find a way to put the puck in the net.
Two periods have been played. And so, as we think back through the first two, we think ahead toward the third.
Hey, fans, now is the time to pick up your team calendars. You can pick them up at kiosk 144 on the board.
D'Agostini's goal was pretty good, but is it the difference maker? It is for right now. We head to break. Two periods played, one period ahead. What are your thoughts so far, Eddie?
Halifax is down in this game, Doc, but they could easily be ahead. Why? Their time of possession. They've had the puck a lot in this game. All they need now is to finish off some of those chances.
Skate kick out of the scrum. Pitching it to Pouliot. Got that pass near the blue line and now looks ahead. Waffle boarded. Perfect, Brister. And ring more bells on that one. One after another. Poked away. Pressure now. The Stampeders have it up the wing. Broken stick, couldn't take it. Great save. What a distraction. Loose puck, the defense was in the way. That was one he'll get the number on.
These plays happen a lot in the middle of the ice because there's a lot of traffic there.
Trying to go to Stewart. Carries it on in from center. Taken to the corner by Stewart. Gets that pass in the corner. Right in front. Score! Two straight goals.
Stewart's anticipation allowed him to get that puck on the backhand and put it in the net.
Enzo, just because you're in the butterfly doesn't mean you can give in to the shooter. You still have to move. He looked like he thought he was in perfect shape to make the stop and didn't have to move. Bad guess.
Just a bit over 4 minutes skated here in the third. At this point, some good offense, some strong defense. Six goals, it's 4-2.
By number four, Juuse Jokinen, and by number 16,
took that away in his own zone.
4 minutes, 8 seconds.
Into the attacking end. Cut that pass in his own end. Has it picked up. To Stallberg. And at an angle to Jeffrey. Halifax continues on in their own end. Cut in half by Stallberg. He takes that point pass. Good intercept in his own end. Out to the half wall. Need to get rid of it. Halifax carrying it up the wing. Bangs it ahead to Klingberg. Taken out along the boards.
It's pretty clear he wanted to send a message with that hit. He followed through and thumped him.
Save there. And he holds. holds on, and the whistle stops play.
Nagostini's a dangerous guy because he can score, but where he really gets to be a handful for the opposition is that he makes the people around him that much more dangerous. If you're playing with him, get yourself to the net, get your stick on the ice and your head up, because a lot of times the puck will be delivered right at the right time.
Fires, and a save.
Hartford's built a lead on the fact that they dominated puck possession. Their goaltender has had a very easy night in there. Hasn't had a lot of shots, but he stopped what he's had to.
The puck's dropped, and that's a great job tying the man up on that faceoff. A shot. Wonderful stop. Play is stopped, and that well-worn track to both penalty boxes will be plowed through again. Halifax gets a two-minute penalty for slashing.
Back in the era of wood sticks, this would really hurt. That's a slash.
A power play that can generate goals is special, and this one has been. Let's see if it continues. He keeps winning draws, and his team gets possession, and they're winning the game. I wonder if there's a connection there. That one is pointed to him. He hangs on and gets the whistle. That's a solid face-off win. Tries to get it on net. Wide. The stick can break up a play, and it just did. The power play unit has to recoil and try yet again. Pitching this one to Jokinen. Brings it in for an attack. Muscled long to Pouliot. It's dumped in. Trying to clear it here. And so that one is cleared, and they check the clock and get ready for more. Now it's directed to Jokinen. Shoots. Wonderful save with the glove. Nice work by Jokinen. Fires! That shot hit a man. Hartford's power play is over. Not too successful tonight. That defuses the attack for now.
The defenders caught a break here. Lots of pressure in their end of the ice, but the goalie freezes the puck and they can catch their breath.
Puck drop, face off one, and the winger stepped right in. Great shooting lane. He missed the net.
Guys, the goalie's not going to keep up to this one. The one-time pass is perfect, but he misses the net.
Directing that one to Stahlberg. Gets across, looks over his options. And thrown down to Jeffrey. Right next to the line. Hatchett's one. He stood in the lane and blocked it. Offside, neutral zone faceoff coming in. And they've won the neutral zone faceoff. Skates it into the zone. That's a goaltender's best friend, a defenseman that can use his stick like that. Propelled to Roosevelt. One-timer, big-time save, big-time shooter. Okay, they've won it. Let's see. Back and forth they go between the points. To the point it comes. Let's it go. Can't get a shot on it. Faces up to the point. Puck picked off. Hartford's in possession as they travel up the wing. Into the corner by LaPierre. Point blast. Outstanding work with the glove. That's a big defensive zone draw win. Nearing the last minute of the third period. Quick wrister. Oh, he got that. They won that faceoff. Can they clear it? Snapping a pass to Jokinen. Puck is thrown to Stewart. Net empty. Score!
That one should put the icing on the cake.
I'll probably put a bow on this one, Edzo. That'll be it.
Solid win at center ice. Now what?
Number 78, Marc-Antoine Fleury.
What a tremendous hit.
Solid hit directly right through the puck carrier. Excellent open ice hit.
Puck loose because of that hit. The Whalers have control of the puck in the defensive zone. Moved along and in. Chip to Miller. Using the point. He throws it there. Stick to some. A howitzer. Makes the stop and holds for the whistle.
That's not really a scoring chance. It's a puck to the net. The goalie gets to handle it and stop it, but not a challenging stop at all.
Critical win of the draw. Nice hit. Anything to slow him down here. With that win, they'll finally put their mark in this series. They'll be playing from behind, so they'll need to be prepared.
It took a few games, but they found a way to solve their opponents, and they can build off of that.
Tournaments are fun, especially when they get to loser goes home, winner moves on. We are at that point. Don't miss our next one. For Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, Mike Emmerich saying so long for now.